as in blues.org.
Evening in Southern California. A time to unwind, kick back, and enjoy some great music. And jazz is indeed great music. The invitation is always open as we play the full spectrum of America's art form. This is Bob Parlocha. Join me tonight as we travel together into the wee small hours of the morning, right here on KPS 88.1.
Welcome to the City of Seal Beach Planning Commission of Wednesday, March 21st, 2012. Can we have someone lead us? Mr. Galbraith, could you lead us in the flag salute, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Can we have the roll call, please?
Commissioner Everson?
Here.
Commissioner Goldberg?
Here.
Commissioner Galbraith?
Here.
Vice Chair Cummings?
Here.
And Chair Musselwhite?
Approval of the agenda is next on the item. By motion of the Planning Commission, this is the time to notify the public of any changes to the agenda, rearrange the order of the agenda, and provide an opportunity for any member of the Planning Commission or staff to request an item be removed from the consent calendar for separate action. Are there any changes anyone would like to make?
Seeing I move we approve the agenda as presented.
All those in favor? Hey, I did it right. 5-0. Okay. Oh, we didn't have a second, did we?
All voted in favor of the motion.
All voted in favor. Okay.
Okay.
There was no dispute. Oral communications. At this time, members of the public may address the Planning Commission regarding any items within the subject matter jurisdiction of the Commission. Pursuant to the Brown Act, the Commission cannot discuss or take action on any items not on the agenda unless authorized by law. Those members of the public wishing to speak are asked to come forward to the microphone, state your name for the record. All speakers will be limited to a period of 5 minutes. Would anyone like to speak? Come, please come to the microphone. Tell us your name and if you're representing anyone.
My name is Darlene Cahoon. Before I proceed, is it all right to address any of the items on the agenda in specific or just
There's an item on the agenda under public hearing. Is that what you would like to speak to?
Yes. So should I wait till that point?
Could you please?
Yes.
Okay. And there was nothing else on the agenda? Okay.
Thanks.
The consent calendar items on the consent calendar are considered to be routine and are enacted by one motion unless prior to enactment a member of the Planning Commission or staff requests a specific item be removed from the consent calendar for separate action. The only item on the consent calendar this evening is the approval of the Planning Commission minutes of March 7th, 2012. Is there a motion and a second?
Move to approve.
Second.
Please vote. Okay, 5-0. There are no scheduled matters, and we'll just move on to our public hearing. Minor use permit 12-3 at B86 Surfside Avenue. Can we have the staff report, please?
Yes, Madam Chair, members of the Commission, this item is for minor use permit 12-3 at B86 Surfside Avenue. The applicant is requesting to construct a non-habitable architectural feature in excess of the 35-foot height limit. Specifically, the applicant is proposing to construct an approximately 9-foot, 9-inch by 9-foot, 10-inch covered roof access structure to exceed the height limit by approximately 2 feet. 7 feet is the maximum height allowed beyond the height limit under a minor use permit, and only a portion of this covered roof access structure will actually exceed the height limit, while the footprint at the roof deck level of the structure is 9 foot 9 by 9 foot 10. It does slope inward as it gets higher beyond the 35-foot height limit, so the actual footprint above 35 feet is a little less than the actual footprint on the roof deck. Staff estimates that the footprint at the 35-foot height is approximately 75 feet, whereas the footprint at the roof deck level is closer to 100 square feet. This particular applicant was before the commission back in February with a similar request for a covered roof access structure and a patio cover. At the Planning Commission meeting at which he appeared, the commission denied that minor use permit. It was denied without prejudice, and the applicant has since eliminated the patio, the covered roof patio, as well as redesigned the covered roof access structure in a more compatible architecture with the original plans and the design of the house. Staff sees no reason to deny the minor use permit and is recommending approval of that use permit. And this concludes staff's report.
Thank you. Are there any questions of the staff? Ms. Cummings?
I have one. Has the Surfside Architectural Review looked at this and made any comments about it?
Yes, they have. The plans were submitted to the Architectural Review Committee, and they have approved the plans as submitted. And those plans were the same plans that you have before you this evening.
Have we received any correspondence from anyone?
We have not received any direct correspondence from anyone in regards to the public notices that were mailed out.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Goldberg, no? Any other? No. Okay. This is the time to open the public hearing, and we will do so now. Is there anyone in the public that would like to get up, and we'll ask the proponent first? Is there anything that you'd like to say? Please come to the mic so the people at home that are riveted to this will be able to hear you.
How are you doing? I'm Mark Pacino from B86 Surfside. The last one we did, the calling didn't approve because it was a patio deck, and I was out of town when they built it, so I just didn't say nothing, and then I tried to get it approved, but the colony denied it. But now I talked to the colony and the guy in charge of the committee, and he told me what to do, and then they approved it. I took a letter to the city with the plans from the colony.
Okay. Thank you for that explanation. And there's someone else here that wants to speak?
Hi, my name is Darlene Cahoon, and I was a former board member on the Surfside Board. During the 2010 March timeframe when we were talking about redoing all the zoning. And I was here with a petition from all of the citizens of Surfside, where we actually signed to maintain and keep privileges to have these covered roof access stairway accesses. And that was primarily due to the fact that the people of Surfside want to make sure that it's safe to be able to get to their roof. With they feel that if they had no covered access, that the roofs, the stairways would be wet and slippery, and it'd be a safety issue more than anything. So I actually was the one who carried this petition around and got all of the people's signatures. So the first reason I'm in front of you is because I was the person that heard from all of the citizens of Surfside as to why we wanted the roof, the stair covered roof access, but also from the four people that did not want to sign the petition. And I need to, in my own conscience, represent them tonight to know, let you know why they didn't want to sign that, okay? Their number one statement was, it will block views, and if we keep having the stair-covered access, then somebody's going to build one that's bigger than just the stairway cover. And if you go through Surfside, you'll see that most of the stairway covers are about the minimum ones are about 3 to 4 by 7 feet long, 3 feet wide by 7 feet long. Others are as big as 8 by 7, but none are as big as 9 by 9, 9.9 by 9.10. All right, so I'm just speaking, first of all, as one of them. And to let you know, the people of Surfside want the covered access, but if they see that you see we're going to take advantage of it and we'll eventually deny it down the road, we want to stay within the confines of the greater good of Surfside and keep them to a size that is pleasing to everybody. So that is the first reason I'm here. The second reason is, as a former board member, I heard these discussions over and over, and everybody went through the architectural committee and tried to get these things approved. So everybody's trying to make it aesthetically pleasing, and I want to say and tell Art that he's done a nice job to make it look nice. What I'm here as a third person is, I own the property right behind him. And once you've taken the height, my argument is not for the height limit. Once you've made the roof access, then you've made the roof access. And when I rebuild on C13, my covered stairway is going to be in the same place as his, but mine's not going to be as wide as his. 9.9 by 9.10 seems a little larger than just the stairway access. You have the plans. I have not seen them. I don't know what they look like. My husband was here last month at this same meeting to tell you we are for people's properties rights. Everybody should have a right to build what they need. If he needs that and you approve it, then so be it. But also to let you know, when we come before you with our plans, we're going to want the same consideration.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there anyone that would have, just a moment, any questions from the commission to the comment?
I just another comment. This was approved by the architectural committee of Surfside, correct?
Okay. Any other questions of anyone who spoke? Now, you wanted to come up, and you're the applicant, so you get to rebut.
You know, I understand that she lives behind me, but when I moved into Surfside, three houses weren't in front of me. When they got built, I didn't say nothing. When they build the house up behind me, the view that I do have from my kitchen, I will no longer have. I'm not going to complain about that either. You know, and as far as A row, B row, and C row, C row has very little view as it is. I don't have a view from my roof over A row. I don't have a view. The only view that was there was the house in front of me, because he doesn't have his parapet walls built up 42 inches plus a doghouse, because he doesn't have roof access. So that's the only view that's from B row through A row. Besides that, there is no view. I can stand on my roof, and I can't see no ocean in front of me. You know, so C row, it's even going to be worse. But, you know, I'm not going to complain when they build up. If it's my view that I do have now, I'll lose. I've never complained, and I've been there since 1985, when all the other construction was done. Thank you.
Thank you.
I have a question for staff and perhaps the applicant. Looking at the roof detail diagram, it looks like that the covered roof access structure extends, by my reading of this, 3 foot 2 inches wider than it would necessarily have to provide a landing for the stairs comes up. And would staff agree with that, or?
Well, on the plan, it does look like it reads that way. What is actually happening with the plan, where the, if you're following along, where the stair comes up to the landing? Building code requires, at the top step of a stair, you need a 3 foot landing. So there is a 3 foot four dimension coming up from the stair. Now the door shifts over towards the middle of the building. And the reason for that is because of the slope of the roof of the covered access structure, they cannot get a proper door height, a 6 foot 8 door height with a header, unless the door is moved inward to a point where the roof is high such that you have that clearance. If they were to put a door directly across from where the top step is, they wouldn't get that 6 foot 8 height out of a door. It would be a shorter door, or they would, I guess another remedy would be they could pull the center wall could be pulled inward back towards the roof structure to reduce the size, but again, to get that door clearance, you'd be making a flat roof structure rather than a sloped roof. So it's kind of a trade-off. The actual footprint of the structure could theoretically be made smaller by making the covered roof access a flat roof structure.
Make it higher.
Which would make it higher all the way across.
Right, so it's flat and high.
The design the applicant is proposing is a shed roof, and only a portion of that shed roof actually peaks beyond the 35 feet, and it extends further in towards the building to get the proper door height out onto the roof deck.
So for the slope roof design, the footprint of this covered roof access structure is fairly minimal for the way this thing is designed.
You could probably carve out a few square feet here and there. I think part of the reason driving this is an architectural aesthetic. I think that, you know, one of the ways that you could reduce the size is, as I just explained, make it a flat roof structure. Now you would have a flat roofed covered roof access, and then a kind of a gable roof or a hip roof coming out from the side. Again, but the way the staircase, the way it's located on the floor plan, if you were to pull that front wall in towards the stair, you'd kind of have an offset facade, which again would be, from an architectural standpoint, I'm not sure how that exactly would read.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? Mr. Everson?
No questions for me, no.
I do have a question.
Okay.
In our discussion on page 3, we have under section 11.2.05.015.A.6, and we have a number of architectural features that are identified in that section. I would like staff to explain to me. It says, and covered access to open roof decks to exceed the height limit established pursuant to another section, Surfside, up to a maximum of 7 feet. In my understanding, this particular structure, as it is being presented, is 2 feet above the 35-foot limit.
At the ridge, at the highest ridge.
At the height. We have established a 35-foot limit in Seal Beach, is that correct?
In the Surfside area, yes. The rest of residential areas in Seal Beach is 25 feet.
Okay, but we do have a 35-foot limit, and this exceeds it by 2 feet.
We have a 35-foot limit established by right. Through a minor use permit, a property owner may request to exceed that 35-foot height limit by up to 7 feet for features such as a covered roof access structure or spires or a cupola or some other type of architectural, non-habitable architectural feature.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Did you have something else you wanted to say? I saw you raising your hand.
Why don't you pass them now? And
that was as of February last month.
That's from, where are those taken from?
From C13.
From C13. Is that directly? Is that directly behind this piece of property?
Are these the same that your husband brought?
Yes.
So we have
okay, we've seen these.
You already have those.
Right. Right.
Okay.
These are the ones that
half of the house has been taken down now.
Yes. The one, yes, that has the tarp. Okay.
Okay. So some of the structure was removed?
Yes.
Correct. The covered patio portions of roughly half of that structure was removed, and the remaining half was redesigned slightly.
What is the pleasure of the commission?
Well, I feel that this is an improvement from the plans that we saw them at the last meeting, and I know that there appears, especially on the top story plan, to be a larger footprint than what is necessary, but I think it's fairly clear when you look at the elevation and the proximity of the door to the roof and to the outside wall, that it would be necessary for that roof to be in that location, or excuse me, for the door to be in that location unless the roof were to change to a flat roof, which in my opinion would then obscure more of you because you're raising more of that roof up into the, up above the height limit. I feel that this plan is the minimum footprint for this particular property unless, as our senior planner said, we're going to request that he carve out square footage sort of in a jigsaw puzzle fashion, which I do worry would compromise the integrity of the architecture for the house. So I guess I would tend to approve this plan.
Are you making a motion?
I'm ready to see if there's no other comments from the commission.
Any other comments?
No.
Okay.
I move to approve minor use permit 12-3.
Second?
Second.
Okay, please vote. And that's 5-0. You're approved.
Approval of minor use permit 12-3 through adoption of resolution 12-4 is a final decision of the Planning Commission. There is a 10-day period to appeal this decision to the City Council. The appeal period begins tomorrow morning.
Thank you. Can we have a director's report, please?
Yes, Madam Chair, just a few items this evening. On April 10th, which is the day after the April 9th City Council meeting, the City Council is scheduled to take up the draft housing element. It was originally scheduled to be part of the Council meeting on Monday, April 9th, but the City's consultant had a prior engagement that evening. So what will happen is the City Council will adjourn at their April 9th meeting. They will adjourn to April 10th at 6 p.m. Here in Council Chambers to take up the matter of the draft housing element. Additionally, we've received a couple plan submittals in the Department of Development Services. First one is the Shorehouse Cafe. We have received a demolition plan for the Shorehouse Cafe. From Regency Centers, it is going through the process right now. I believe our Public Works Department is just about ready to approve the grading. What they propose to do is demolish the existing structure and then reconfigure the parking lot and landscaping to add approximately 21 more parking spaces. So combined with the removal of a use that had a parking demand of 40-plus parking spaces, and then replace that structure with 21 more parking spaces will be a considerable parking improvement for the Seal Beach Center.
Pretty remarkable.
Secondly, we've received plans for the Sofa You Love building, I believe, at 770 Pacific Coast Highway. It's right there on the corner of 8th and PCH. We have plans for the remodel of that building to be converted to a eye clinic.
A what?
Eye clinic, medical use.
Oh, eye clinic.
So those plans have been submitted for a conceptual coastal review. They are proposing to add a small amount of square footage to the building, but they have adequately parked that additional square footage in addition to the parking demand for the medical use. So that is making its way through the process as well.
Good.
Other than that, that's all I have for this evening. We do, if you look at your agenda forecast, we currently have no items scheduled for the month of April for Planning Commission, so would be a good time to take vacations if anyone is planning on that. But the second meeting, as always, is subject to change depending on if we do get something in. But for right now, we're not forecasting any items for either of those meetings.
Okay. Are there any? Go ahead.
At Fresh and Easy, do things seem to be settling in there well and the neighbors comfortable?
As far as I know, yes, but I see we have a neighbor in the audience this evening. She might be able to, if she's willing, she might be able to give a better firsthand opinion of what might be happening at Fresh and Easy. I don't know. Linda, did you want to say anything? You don't have to.
Quiet.
Why don't you come forth? Yeah, so everybody can hear.
Sorry to put you on the spot.
They seem to be doing pretty well. There's a lot more foot traffic down 8th Street. We still have a lot of problem with parking, and now that I hear Sofa You Love is going to be doing something and then more construction going on, not really excited about that. Fresh and Easy is quieter. They get their deliveries late at night, but overall it seems like, you know, a lot of the residents are coming around and it looks pretty good. So, and they seem to be taking care of things. I do have a couple of issues with them that hopefully they're taking care of now or working on. Any questions?
Thank you.
Have you all been down there and checked it out?
No, not yet.
I was there the first day.
You were? It's a nice store. The colors are nice, and they've done a really nice job on the outside of the building, and it's been pleasant working with them. So, thank you.
They followed through on the commitment they made to you to replace the windows and do some work on your home?
They did. They replaced my two windows that needed to be replaced in the bedroom. And they went ahead and did really nice landscaping between the brick wall and the back of the building, so I'm not so concerned about people coming through. They've put the gates up and stuff. But there is the lighting back there is a little strong. So I'm working with them on doing something about that one light that's right under my bedroom window. And then there is a little bit of an issue with the watering still, because I had that problem with water coming under and stuff, and they've been working on that. And we're kind of in a holding pattern because it's still winter and we're still getting water and stuff, so hopefully that will be resolved.
I noticed there was a little water problem and actually in the flower beds in the front too, so it's something they're probably going to have to work on a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm glad to hear things are...
Yeah, we just need permit parking on my side of the street. That'd be nice.
So I'm sure you'll take it up with the council.
Yes,
outside our...
Actually, just to add a little bit more about what Linda said at the end there, our Public Works Department is currently working through that process to see what they can do about the parking situation along 8th Street.
Good. Anything else, Mr. Director?
Not this evening. Senior Planner.
How about commission concerns, Mr. Goldberg?
I just had a question. Is the DWP EIR still on schedule for April 2nd?
Mr. Attorney?
I believe it is.
Thank you.
That's the latest I've heard, so I haven't heard any changes in the schedule.
Ms. Cummings?
I think that's all. I'm happy Fresh and Easy's up, In-N-Out's up.
Yeah.
And now Denny's looks like they're very close. They've replaced all the concrete in front and looks like they're almost ready.
They have a few outstanding items they're still working on at Denny's, but we expect that sometime within the next month they should be ready to go. And just to kind of add a little more to In-N-Out, I'm sorry. I've actually been out there a couple times over the past week at lunch just to see how things are going. And I will say that, and I don't know if this has to do with the grand opening, hopefully this isn't something they'll do indefinitely because I would see their labor costs going through the roof. But both times I've been out there at lunch during the week, they've had no less than three or four employees out there, either, you know, setting up cones when the traffic starts to get a little out there, and they have people out there with the electronic menu boards, you know, which was a condition of approval that when the drive-through line hit a certain point that they would send people out there. And that's kind of their corporate policy anyway. But they've had, on one occasion I saw actually the store manager out there just kind of, you know, greeting people as they were driving up and keeping track of things. So it looks like they're doing a good job so far of doing what they're supposed to be doing.
I was a little disappointed because we had talked about vegetation along the entry road into the parking lot, and actually what they replaced is not as high as the old was, but I'm assuming it's going to grow.
Well, there are a couple things there as well. That was a concern of ours on the In-N-Out side. What we're dealing with is a very small portion of that landscape strip, part of the In-N-Out lease space, and the bulk of it part of the center's space. There's a bioswale there. And in the wintertime, they usually cut those bioswales back quite severely. The type of planting that's in there tends to grow very fast. So I would imagine that the bioswale itself will start within the next month or two. You'll start seeing some substantial growth in there. With the In-N-Out side, where the Japanese privet is planted along the drive-through, this was something that I went back and forth with them a couple times, and I actually had a discussion with the chair regarding that landscaping. For them to plant mature plants, they felt would be... it would be quite an expense, as well as once you plant a mature plant and then it grows, now you're having to kind of cut it back. When I first brought this concern up with them, they consulted a horticulturist who submitted a letter that said, you know, because of the type of plant, the watering system, and the fertilization system that they have, they expected that within a growing season that hedge would be as high as 3 feet. When I asked our own, the city's arborist, as to what his opinion was as far as the planting, he seemed to think that that might be a little ambitious, but, you know, not completely out of the realm of possibility. But he seemed to think that, you know, maybe within a growing season, no more than two, that they would have a fully mature hedge out there. If you look at closer to where the Chipotle building is, that started out roughly as the same size as what you see now at In-N-Out. And in the span of Chipotle's been there a little over a year now, I think, it is full and solid, and it is approximately 3 feet high. So, you know, we didn't get exactly what we wanted right out of the gate, but I think within short order we should be looking okay there.
Nothing from me tonight.
Well, since the director has indicated that people can take a vacation in April, I will be gone from the 13th of April to the 30th of April.
He just made those reservations on his iPhone.
do we have any further information about the stats building, the third tenant in there yet? Or?
You know, that came up earlier today, and I need to make a phone call to the gentleman who's in charge of a lot of the stuff that goes on out at the center.
So it would be premature to say anything about
it. Well, I, the last I heard is that they did have a tenant. I just was not made aware of who exactly it was. At one time, I know BevMo was looking at it, but they've since backed out, and I'm not sure who stepped in behind them.
Thank you.
To get back to the In-N-Out drive-through landscape, the purpose of the landscaping along the driveway was to obscure the cars parked in that long driveway. And I think that we were not clear enough, and I'm only saying this so that if we ever get another drive-through restaurant and we have to approve it, we should be more clear, if that's English, more clear, in terms of how we want those driveways to be obscured. In my mind, my vision of that, when we were talking about it at the meeting, was that there would be mounding, and then on the top of the mounding, you put the landscaping. Ergo, you've already got 3 feet blocking the cars, and then you put the landscape on top of that, and you've got even more obscure line of sight. So next time, maybe the you all will be on the Planning Commission, and we'll make sure that those kinds of things are in the conditions of approval.
Okay. Maybe perhaps we should reserve for the discussion of the topic to until it's agendized for discussion.
Well, I'm not asking for anyone to comment, and I'm not asking for anything, just making my own personal comment.
Commissioner Concern.
Well, I think it was a combination of things, and my vision wasn't their vision, and I didn't express my vision clearly.
And the ownership has changed, too. The people that were at that meeting representing the owners of the property.
That's true. Well, yeah, but
I think there are several
things. In-N-Out, you know, it's In-N-Out's landscape plan, really.
Yeah, but it, the
and we should have, I just
shopping center is responsible for a good portion of that.
Yeah, but I should have realized that. Anyway, next time. We'll do it next time. But if there are no, yes, Mr.
Could,
Bell.
I ask a question. What is the status of the Rite Aid property?
We have received no updates from Rite Aid. They have not submitted anything to our building department or public works, that's another question I can certainly ask when I make a phone call tomorrow.
They didn't run into any more dirty soil.
I don't believe so. I think they've for the most part finished with the remediation out there.
Those, the buildings that have been people have moved out of, the Kentucky Fried Chicken and Verizon are not very attractive in their current state.
They're not getting any prettier as days go on, I'm sure.
So we have an application for demolishing those buildings yet?
We don't have an application, but my understanding is that is the eventual plan to demolish those buildings.
Thank you. Thank you. Anyone else? Okay, meeting's adjourned.